This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed
to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
First and 10, Hill. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And this one is incomplete.
Thus far, they have been able to move the line of scrimmage very well in the running game. Almost felt like they said in the huddle, can you guys pass protect? Let's take a...
Play fake, Hill. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. And the Ravens are going to take possession of the football. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you. And you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. After the interception, here's Jackson. He'll dump this off complete to Dobbins. Touchdown! J.K. Dobbins on his way to a monster game. Three first-half touchdowns. And the Ravens have broken the tie. Now Tucker to add the PAT. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14.
Makes the score Ravens 21, Saints 14. Justin Tucker as you kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. He will return this from deep in the end zone.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. Hill on first down. Flushed out right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play. And he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
19 tight, 19 tight.
To throw again on second down, Hill. That's caught inside the 20. And they're going to be set up now with a ball at the 13-yard line.
A lot of running backs in the passing game, They're just used to check it down to them or maybe dump off passes. This guy, they use him to stretch the field, don't they?
Stretched it right there, turned it into a really nice game. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Now it's Hill. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. There he goes, right side. And the Ravens are going to take possession of the football. I'm not sure that the wheels, Charles, are coming completely off, but they're shaking a little bit. That's three interceptions, and now interceptions here on back-to-back drives.
And I think about what a Hall of Fame coach told me, that he always told his teams, when a mistake happens, just move on to the next play. Let it go. Hard to do when you throw this many interceptions.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Alante Taylor. And the Saints are going to have it here at their own 9-yard line. Well, these defensive coaches, they sure like what they've got in this rookie corner. And with good reason, as you saw there.
He only cost him a day two pick, and a lot of people thought he had first round ability. But when he was available on draft night, that was one where you didn't need the full time to make the selection. You call that pick in early, and he shows why he was so coveted with that interception there.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Here's Hill now after the interception. They got the ball now following a big play, keeping the other guys out of the end zone. Now they'll start deep in their own territory, first and 10. Another try after the first down sack. Hill. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish, because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
Third and long, it's Hill. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
I think it's safe to say that he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Forced some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down.
The return is Prochet. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Set at the line for this next drive. And two interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw two interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny Unitas?
And no, not quite of that level and not of that age. But I remember looking over at him, and he was smiling. And I thought, what is he smiling about? It's because he had enough confidence in himself that was a fluke. And he went out and played pretty well the rest of the day.
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Play action. It's Jackson. Open man is Duvernay. And he's got a first down following a pickup of about 13, as we will take a pause here for the two-minute warning. It's a gain of 13 for number 13, and it gives him a first down. Here's Jackson. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here on this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. Option play, and they'll hand to Dobbins. And maybe a little over pursuit there as he's able to take this down to the 25-yard line. 52 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times. And this one almost intercepted. Had a chance to come down with it in the end zone, but could not hang on. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. A little second effort there on the strong run. And then drop just inside of the 20. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. This will be the eighth play of the drive here. Third and four. Play action. Now Jackson. That's going to be caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins on his way to a historic performance. Four first half touchdowns. And the Ravens have taken a two touchdown lead now. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And the lead now up to 14. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
Now Hill looking to throw on first. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Boy, a pair of big plays here. This one going for 29.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And he's going to get this down near the 25.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Again on second down, Hill. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
Throwing once more. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And the Ravens are going to have it here at their own 15. Well, CD, you know, when you mentioned earlier about spreading the ball around in this game, I don't think you mentioned the guys in the other uniform. With four interceptions here in the first half, and several different guys have picked them off.
Yeah, instead of analyzing what's going wrong with him, throwing the football while we look at the defense. They came in prepared.
Oh, for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. Marcus May with a pick. And the Saints are going to take possession of the football. Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. The Ravens ready to receive it, and they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half.